Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to a little something different.
We are more than we are one.
I wish that I could bake a cake made out of rainbows and smiles and we'd all eat and be happy.
Do you even go to this school?
No, I just have a lot of feelings.
Okay, go home.
But recently, a lot of the books that I've been reading have definitely come across with a lot of themes of women's struggles. And it kind of got me thinking, does anyone else kind of get tired of reading fiction? Because we're so often just in the heads of other people and seeing other people's stories, and some of them can be pretty tragic or just difficult. Like, even if it's not like you're reading about like death or murder or really intense stuff, some of the stuff can still just be exhausting because of the really small, like minute, like microaggressions that some people, some races, and you know, some genders face all the time. And so I was kind of wondering, does anybody else just feel like just really tired sometimes reading all this stuff? I feel like books, it's a lot different than like a movie or a TV show where you can sort of just like go in for 30 minutes or like an hour and a half and then kind of be done with it after that. You know, it's really quick to get through some of that stuff. But with books, I mean, I guess depending on how fast you are as a reader, you really get in very deep and really kind of discover and go through a lot of this stuff that can be pretty harsh. And you really kind of learn a lot about these characters and you're with them for a really long time, and it's quite a struggle. And I'm kind of going to stop beating around the bush here, because I know, because you guys already saw the title, but I'm really specifically talking about women in fiction. There's been so many books lately that I've been reading about where I'm just exhausted by like the injustice and the terrible things that like women have to go through in these books, and I'm sorry. I'm so fortunate as a white man, and I do apologize if you don't need my white man tears or, you know, like me white knighting or anything. But like, I'm just so sorry, or I just feel so fortunate that I can just, you know, escape from these books to go play a video game, which we'll actually get into later, which is a very terrible place for women. But I can just go escape and I can, you know, do something that doesn't have... I can escape from all this quite easily. I don't have to like actually live through this every day. And, you know, I just feel so much empathy and, you know, sorrow for what women have to go through. And I know not everyone's the same, but I feel like almost every woman does have a story about being, you know, harassed for maybe the smallest things, as like looks going through the street, to the most horrific things that you can possibly imagine. And I'm just tired and I'm exhausted, and it just kind of saddens me that there are people, that women out there, It's your life. It's not just a story. It's something you guys have to deal with like every single day. And I'm just so sorry for that. And honestly, that's kind of all this video is really just a discussion. I really just kind of wanted to talk about this. I don't exactly need to spread awareness of it. I'm sure a lot of people are aware. But I just want to talk about this. You know, I've been reading, like I said, a lot of books lately. I mean, just over roughly the last 6 months, I've been exposed to things like The Poppy War, Crown of Feathers, Ray Bearer, the Grishaverse, like the Six of Crows duology, and King of Scars. And then the book that tipped me over to finally making this video is I'm currently reading through The Sword of Kaigen. All of these books have varying ranges of dealing with the injustices or the difficult lives and positions that women are sometimes forced to live. You know, you have stuff like The Sword of Kaigen and The Poppy War where women aren't allowed to do a lot of things. They're heavily looked down upon. The Poppy War definitely has a lot of brutal sexual, you know, murder and assault. And I feel like this probably hits the highest tier of exhaustion, where it's kind of just like that's the way the world is and there's not really a redemption to it. Sword of Kaigen's kind of like that middle ground where our main character definitely can't do a lot as a woman. She's not supposed to do a lot as a woman. But there are definitely other cultures that do allow that, and it's not the norm. So that's kind of like a middle ground to where, you know, there are some parts of this story that women are not allowed to do anything, are not allowed to be treated as equal to men. But there is some redemption there. There is some characters, there are some places where this is not the norm, and that's nice to read about. Six of Crows is another really good example, kind of like that, where it's not as bad as Sword of Kaigen. There's mostly just one country that deals with women basically not being equal and kind of being less than, and that is dealt with one of the characters, Nina Zenik. But personally, I really love the way this handles a relationship where two people of opposing factions or sides really come together and change each other for the better. I think it's a very beautiful relationship. Not every, you know, woman's problem has to be solved by finding the right guy, but I think that story does it really well. And then there's, of course, the, like, rose-tinted stories, where pretty much there is no really division between men and women. I can't think about a specific book, but I definitely wanted to point out Avatar The Last Airbender.
There's no way a bunch of girls took us down.
A bunch of girls, huh? I'm a survivor, I'm not gonna give up.
Yourself, you were never even a player.
There are some amazing female characters, from Katara to Toph to Azula. They're all very different females, all with their own different strengths, and they're all incredible, and it doesn't really matter that they're women. There's just one small part in chapter one where it does deal with a certain place not treating women right, but that's pretty quickly taken care of, and that was really nicely sort of wrapped up in a bow and sent off.
I'm sorry. I think there's been a misunderstanding. In our tribe, it is forbidden for women to learn waterbending.
You have someone to practice with, and I get to learn waterbending. Everyone's happy.
I'm not happy.
But you're never happy.
You have disrespected me, my teachings, and my entire culture.
No way am I apologizing to a sour old man like you!
Grand-Grand wouldn't let your tribe's stupid customs run her life. That's why she left. It must have taken a lot of courage.
Hey, Katara!
What do you think you're doing?
It's past sunrise. You're late.
Good to see you here.
You too.
And so, yes, obviously that could be a solution, really, to, you know, maybe reading so many of these stories is to escape to a different story that has that rose-tinted world. And that's kind of nice to see. I'd kind of like to know your guys' thoughts down below. Do you guys ever kind of feel like this? Is there any sort of, like, hard messaging or really difficult stories that you kind of read a lot of where sometimes you kind of wish to escape to a different thing? I'm sure that's not a very bookwormish kind of thing to say, but personally I really like to escape to, you know, obviously my art or movies, TV shows, and most recently video games. There's unfortunately a very horrible case going on right now with one of the most popular video games out there that everyone's probably heard about, World of Warcraft. Their company is actually just recently in the past week being taken to court because of their very horrible, like, frat boy like atmosphere and environment at their company. It's absolutely horrible, some of the stories that are coming out about this. They're honestly so bad that you would think that this can't possibly be true. I'm not saying any of the women or even some of the men are lying about this, but it's definitely something to where, like, this is something where I need the justice system to declare them guilty for, because it's unbelievable that people would act like this, and it's just so horrible. It kind of leads me to a more maybe controversial thing I want to talk about, and that's power fantasy. You know, like I mentioned the word earlier, white knight, and it's not that necessarily I always want to see myself as the hero or that I need to save women. Honestly, the ideal situation is that women won't need to be saved, they won't need to be stood up for. But there are so many situations where you hear about where women can't stand up for themselves, and you just wish that you were in that situation to say something. And it's honestly not just about gender equality this happens with. There's honestly a lot of times where, you know, I'm not the most attractive or coolest guy, and I wasn't back in high school, but it always would have been nice to be that person that's so above the popular people BS that, like, if someone's getting bullied, you can easily step in and it's not going to ruin your life or anything like that. You know, you have the power to be able to stop people. And I recently talked about in this book, The Shadow War, which is basically like a power fantasy story about teenagers back in World War II who have powers to be able to stop the Nazis. And it can even be something as fantastical as that. Sometimes you just fantasize about wanting to be able to have the powers to stop, you know, these atrocities, no matter how fantastical it is. It's just a thing that I really think about a lot. I think as readers, one of the greatest things that we can learn and gain from reading is empathy for other people and other struggles. So I do find myself a lot of the times imagining these situations where things could be better. And, you know, it's just hard to read about these a lot. And that's kind of where you need to find that line of what kind of story are you looking for? Are you looking for total realism to where, you know, the life sucks, the world sucks, women are not treated well, and that's just how it is? Do you want more of like redemption story to it, to where, you know, they are facing injustices, but they overcome them or get back at the bad guy, stuff like that? Or do you want just like a rose-colored world where everything is kind of like, their gender isn't an issue? And then recently, I know there's definitely been some stories where I feel like we should just expect more out of, you know, female representation in books, and we shouldn't settle. Two recent books I definitely read was The Gilded Ones and Spin the Dawn. You know, both these books, they definitely covered some of these like issues of, you know, the injustices and the equality between genders, and some of them just weren't done really well. Some of them, like, you know, they have the opportunity to, you know, have women standing up for women, and they just didn't really go there. It went more of like a love route, and that's so not fun to read about. Like I said, it's done really well in Six of Crows, but most of the time it's not done well when the only option for women to become equal or to get over this hurdle is to just find a man. And there's stuff like The Gilded Ones where the issues are so just like hitting you in the face with like absolutely no nuance, and then it doesn't really explore that, you know, to every character. Like, especially this book, there was just the main character and her issues, and it kind of got muddled by the end, and all the other, you know, side characters, the females, they never got any of like their own time. So it was just all kind of this big mess and muddled. And I just think that females definitely deserve a lot better representation, a lot better stories. And I'm sure they're out there. I mean, I know they're out there. There's tons of great stories like that. So like I said, I don't really know where I'm going with this. I just kind of wanted to start this conversation. You know, like I said, comment anything you've already thought about down below while you've been watching this video. I'll take all shades of comments or recommendations. You know, let me know some of the stories that you've read recently that really struck home for you. Let me know how you feel maybe about, in general, reading about really tough topics so often in fiction, and how does that make you feel? Do you feel exhausted reading about so many issues? Do you love it? Is it like bittersweet or like a double-edged sword? I just want you guys to know that I'm an ally for you guys, and I want to empathize with you, and I'm always here to support all my female viewers and my fellow female content creators. I mean, you girls on BookTube make some incredible videos, incredible content, and it's so awesome to see what you guys do. So, you know, any readers or video creators out there, you know, let me know down below what some of your favorite books are that have this representation, or maybe show these struggles really well, or maybe just talk about some books that, like I said, that have that rose-colored world, like Avatar: The Last Airbender. What are some stories? What are some of your favorite female characters? There's just so much stuff you guys can comment about. It's just a day where I really want to talk about women and your stories. If you want to share your own personal stories, then I'd love to listen and, you know, empathize with you. Or if you want to talk about some of your really great stories, or, you know, if you want to just share some awesome news that you haven't really had to struggle with that. I mean, like me personally, again, this doesn't really count because like I'm a white person, but, you know, me growing up, racism really wasn't a thing. Like, where I grew up, there wasn't really racism. I didn't feel it. I didn't grow up with any negative stereotypes towards people of color. And so, you know, maybe there are women who have lived similar lives where they've grown up and not really had an issue. So, you know, there's hope that someday we'll all live in a world without racism, without gender stereotypes, and without inequality. So yeah, there's just so much stuff that we can talk about, and I love to hear any side of the story here. We have so many options that you can comment on. So let me know your thoughts down below. I hope you guys enjoyed this weird video. I hope the clickbait title didn't scare you off. And yeah, that's pretty much going to be it for me, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, go ahead and like and subscribe. Hit that bell notification so you always know when you're getting my random TED Talks. You also can find me on all my social media linked down below. I'm on Instagram, Goodreads, and Twitter. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye now. With pride.